Good to see you all, you know.
It's good to see anybody.
Keith Richards, guitarist of the Rolling Stones and co-writer of most of their hits. This man has tons of cool stories to tell, and in this short video I'm going to tell you a bit about my experience with reading this book so that you can decide for yourself if you want to read it as well. Let's begin. Hello everybody! Earlier this week I finally finished reading this book, which is one of the longest books I have read at over 600 pages. It actually started pretty slow and it took me some time to get just through the first third of the book. But once the career of the Rolling Stones really starts to pick up in the mid to late 70s and the stories start to get crazier and crazier, I just couldn't put the book down, and in the last week and a half I read over 400 pages, which is way more than the average pace of how I'm reading books. So what was it that made me pick up this book? I always loved the Rolling Stones, but I was never really a diehard fan, and I was a bit skeptical in the beginning about whether I really want to spend all this time and read this book. What did make me want to do it is just that I know how much Keith Richards is really a legend, and all the stories he has to tell must be interesting, and also the way that he's wrote Crossroads with so many other legends of rock and roll, the Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, all these people that he met and intersected with throughout the way, so I wanted to learn more about it. And I think I was right. Let's keep going. She blew my nose and then she blew my mind. The main thing that I really loved about the book is that, unlike many other autobiographies with focus a bit too much, in my opinion, on all the surroundings of the music, like the drugs and the girls and all that kind of stuff, and there is plenty of that in this book and it's fun as well, but in this book he also focuses a lot on the songwriting and on the guitar playing, and he doesn't let the musician readers down. He talks a lot about his breakthroughs in his guitar playing, some interesting things that he found out along the way, and he also, what I found out in this book, is that I always used to see him mostly as a guitarist, and I didn't know he co-wrote with Mick Jagger almost all of the band's songs. So that essentially makes him one of the top songwriters of all time. And if you are into songwriting, there are plenty of gems and plenty of inspiring stories that he tells about how certain songs were written and on his view about the craft of songwriting and stuff like this, which was really fascinating to read. So this is something that I really loved about this book. Now on to the more juicy stuff. Keith Richards has been known throughout all of the years as one of the biggest party people and craziest party people, even among the rock star crowd. And he has a huge amount of crazy stories to tell in this department about sex, drugs, groupies, everything like that. It's very candid and it's also very fun to read. So if you're into these type of things, you won't be disappointed. One example that comes to my mind is that he tells a story of how he was with one of the other bandmates in the hotel room during the tour, and they look outside the window of the hotel in one of the upper floors, and they see hundreds of screaming groupies, and he just points at one of the girls, asks someone to go and get her, and 5 minutes later she's in his room. Very unpolitically correct in today's world, but this is the cool part about this book, is that without any shame he shares all those stories, and it's a very fun, candid view. And you said one word to me, and that was dead. I said that you can't always get what you want, honey. And you cannot always get the man that you want. This is it. One last thing. I really had a much better time while reading the book, because I started watching a lot of interviews and I really got to see how he is such a cool and also a humble person. Today he's like a cool grandpa, but of course he wasn't like that in his younger years. But it was just really cool to get into his mind and to really read what he taught and how everything unfolded. So this also makes for a good recommendation, I think, for any other book that you read, autobiography of such a musician, that if you accompany it throughout the reading with some interviews on YouTube, it's going to really bring it to life and make the experience much more interesting.
You know, if there's one way to die, you know, it might as well be it, pal.
The bottom line, it's a long book, again, but I think that if you are into this kind of stuff, and especially if you like the Rolling Stones, you're going to immensely enjoy reading it. And even if you're not that really into Keith Richards and all that kind of stuff, you might even just want to pick it up, even just to skim through it, because at any point that you read through the book, you will encounter something inspiring, something funny, something cool. So this is it, Keith Richards, Life. Highly enjoyable, highly recommended. Have a great time and I will see you. Goodbye.